Ramon Stephen, also known as Noah, of Williamson Road, St. George's, passed away on Thursday, 15 February 2024, at the age of 96. He was the father of Joylyn, Edward, Brenda, Paul, and Allison. Grandfather of Darnell, Keja, Andrea, Ella, Jacob, Marie, Kevin, Donna, Charlotte, and Lorraine. Great-grandfather of nine. Father-in-law of Curtis, Dennis, and Osbert. Uncle of many, including Gail, Stella, Francis, and the Jones family in the United Kingdom. Brother-in-law of Raymond and Norma. Other relatives, friends, and caretakers, including Claudius, Dominic, Gwen, Anne, Mr. and Mrs. Roberts, Mrs. Hercules, Miss B of Williamson Road, and friends and neighbors of Williamson Road and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Ramon Stephen, also known as Noah, of Williamson Road, St. George's, will take place on Tuesday, March 26th at 11 a.m. Funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill, St. George's, according to Anglican rites, and entombment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Cynthia Licorice, also known as Miss Cynthia of Providence, St. David, who resided at Tontine Terrace, St. George's, passed away on Wednesday, 13 March 2024, at the age of 79. She was the mother of Dunstan, Cheryl, and Frances Licorice, grandmother of many, including Siobhan and Ryan Licorice, sister of Hamilton Licorice, Doris in Grenada, and John in Trinidad. Many nieces, nephews, cousins, other relatives, and close friends, including Merlin, Maureen, and Rochelle, the Licorice family of St. David, Grand Roy, and Black Bay, and friends and neighbors of Providence, St. David, and Tontine Terrace, St. George's. The funeral of the late Cynthia Licorice, also known as Miss Cynthia, of Providence, St. David, who resided at Tontine Terrace, St. George's, will take place on Tuesday, 26th March at 2 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception, Church Street, St. George's, and interment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Louisa Griffith, also known as Mrs. Sisley of Beausejour, St. George, passed away on Monday, 11th March 2024, at the age of 96. She was the mother of Anne Edwards, Maureen Griffith Joseph, Thomas Griffith, Eve Griffith Okai in Ghana, West Africa, Elizabeth Griffith, and Claudette Alder in England. Grandmother of 21, including Garvin Edwards, Marcia Jones, Dean Johnson, Stuart, Michelle Griffith, Maria Joseph, Celia Joseph, Tiffany Harrison, Tavares Griffith, Kaylee Griffith, Carrie Griffith, Elliot and Theo Alder, Edward Blankson, Nancy Kately Okai, and Cameron Okai, all in England, and Mark Joseph in St. Lucia. Mother-in-law of Rex Edwards, William Okai, and Kevin Alder. Great-grandmother of 19. Great-great-grandmother of 2. Aunt of Verona Williams, Val and Armstrong Johnson, June Richardson, Karen Dowden, and Doctors Dion Forrester and Jude Entwine. Caregiver, Miss Jenny Cornwall. Other relatives and friends, including Mr. and Mrs. Maitland of Beausejour, the Johnson family of The Fence, Grenville Vale and New Hampshire, and friends and neighbors of Beausejour, Happy Hill and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Louisa Griffith, also known as Mrs. Sisley of Beausejour, St. George, will take place on Wednesday, 27th March at 12:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Uganda Martyrs RC Church, Happy Hill, St. George, according to Anglican rites, and entombment will be at the Top Fence Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Benedict John Polite of Corinth, St. David, who resided at Florida, St. John, passed away on Saturday, 2nd March 2024, at the age of 72. He was the close and dear friend of Cicely Ann Chetram, father of many, including Cindy Ann, Paul, Peter, James and Anika Chetram, Danny and Betty Ann Williams, Evadne and Clevroy Harry and Jenna, stepfather of Cheryl Ann Chetram Charles and Sharon Walters, grandfather of many, including Chantal, Preston, Iva, Avion, Wyatt and Caleb, brother of James Mahone and Alice Thomas, brother-in-law of Dennis Thomas. Many cousins are the relatives and close friends, including Ellen Charles, Akoda, Kanasha, Akadon, Jada, Ellen Walters, Ella, Ranisha Fletcher, Jean Jeffrey and family, the Licorice and Hippolyte families of St. David, the Chetram family of Florida, and friends and neighbors of St. David, Guave, Brothers, Florida and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Benedict John Polite of Corinth St. David, who resided at Florida St. John, will take place on Wednesday 27th March at 1 p.m. Funeral service and interment will be held at the Douglaston Cemetery, according to Spice Isle Ministry Light of the Nation Rites. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Victor Francis, also known as Rastaman, of Mardi Gras St. George, a well-known farmer, died on Wednesday, March 6th, 2024, at the age of 63, left to mourn his son Keith Warner Joseph, grandchildren Tia, Khalil, Tonya, Rishon, Keith Warner, Kiwani, Elizabeth, Kalima, Alpha, Kiwana, and Kamaya, great-grandchildren Rika, Michael, and baby Tonya, daughter-in-law Marcel, close friends and relatives Asa McIntyre and family, Dale Gilbert and family, Najuma Thomas and family, the Francis family of Mardi Gras and the Joseph family of Grand Mall, Auntie Naomi Sayers, and cousin Claudette Cox of Mardi Gras. The funeral service for the late Victor Francis, also known as Rastaman, of Mardi Gras St. George, will take place on Wednesday 27th March at 1:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Mardi Gras IPA House of Prayer Sanctuary, Mardi Gras, and interment will be at the Mount Airy Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Claire Wildman of Satire St. Patrick, who resided at Egmont St. George, retired manager of Republic Bank, passed away on Thursday, March 7th, 2024, at the age of 69, left to mourn her sister Yolande, brothers Trevor and Leonard, also Carly, Aaron, Kenny, Verlin, Doyle, Doreen, Matthew, Dudley and Daniel, uncle Cyril Mukram, nieces and nephews Nia, Ron, Romel, Ariel, Trent, Hannah, Dylan, Killen, Calandra, and many others, caretakers Anne Mark and Godfrey Andrews, friends Cleopatra Lambert, Evadne, Teresa, Merlin, Carvel, Esther, Frankie and Brian, other relatives and friends including the Wildman family of Sotheres and Diego Peace, Christine Mukram, and the management and staff of Republic Bank. The funeral of the late Claire Wildman of Sotheres St. Patrick, who resided at Egmont St. George, will take place on Thursday, March 28th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Sotheres Evangelical Church, and interment will be at the Marley Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. A memorial service for the late Louise Agnes Cador and Margaret Mary Forrester of Grand Roy St. John will be held on Friday, 5th April at 2 p.m. at the Grand Roy Catholic Church. Arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Muriel Bell, also known as Tanti of Woburn St. George, died on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 79. The funeral arrangements for the late Muriel Bell, also known as Tanti of Woburn St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Irene Bartholomew, also known as Maybell Bartholomew of Granton, New Hampshire St. George, died on Friday, 22nd March 2024. At the age of 98. The funeral arrangements for the late Irene Bartholomew, also known as Maybell Bartholomew of Granton, New Hampshire, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Zephrin Panchu of Sab St. Andrew passed away on Sunday, 18th February 2024, at the age of 89. The funeral arrangements for the late Zephrin Panchu of Sab St. Andrew will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repair center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Esther Patterson of Lauriston Carriacou, a student of the Hillsborough Secondary School, passed away on Friday, March 8, 2024, at the age of 14. The funeral arrangements for the late Esther Patterson of Lauriston Carriacou will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. Veda Cynthia Wells, née St. Cyr, also known as Granny, Gran-Gran and Teacher Veda, of Ladigue St. Andrew, passed away on Sunday, 17th March 2024, at the age of 88. The funeral arrangements for the late Veda Cynthia Wells, née St. Cyr, also known as Granny, Gran-Gran and Teacher Veda, of Ladigue St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. James Patrick, also known as Yeri, of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, passed away on Sunday, 25th February 2024, at the age of 78. The funeral arrangements for the late James Patrick, also known as Yeri of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. Neddy Albert Hayward, also known as Dido, of Mount Parnassus, St. George, passed away on Monday, 18th March 2024, at the age of 84. The funeral arrangements for the late Neddy Albert Hayward, also known as Dido, of Mount Parnassus, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. Raymond Davis Lewis, also known as Briner, of Brooklyn Concord, St. John, passed away on Sunday, 17th March 2024, at the age of 84. The funeral arrangements for the late Raymond Davis Lewis, also known as Briner, of Brooklyn Concord St. John, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. Joseph Ben, also known as Toto Man, of Trinidad, who resided at Belmont St. George, died on Friday, March 8, 2024, at the age of 63. The funeral arrangements for the late Joseph Ben, also known as Toto Man, of Trinidad, who resided at Belmont St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Nola Noel of Bylands, who resided at Mirabeau St. Andrew, passed away on Saturday, March 16, 2024, at the age of 61. The funeral arrangements for the late Nola Noel of Bylands, who resided at Mirabeau St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. Vanessa Harford, also known as Nessie and Nessa, of St. James St. Andrew, who resided at Redgate St. David, passed away on Thursday, March 14, 2024, at the age of 32. The funeral arrangements for the late Vanessa Harford, also known as Nessie and Nessa, of St. James St. Andrew, who resided at Redgate St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Elisha Joseph, also known as Diddy, of Hope St. Andrew, who resided in England, passed away on Sunday, 3rd March 2024, at the age of 87. The funeral arrangements for the late Elisha Joseph, also known as Diddy, of Hope St. Andrew, who resided in England, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Marvin Neptune, also known as Marvo, of Felix Park, Crowshoe, St. Andrew, passed away on Friday, March 8, 2024, at the age of 50. The funeral arrangements for the late Marvin Neptune, also known as Marvo, of Felix Park, Crowshoe, St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Anderson Charles Bain, also known as Maskey and Brother B, of Fontenoy St. George, passed away on Saturday, 9th March 2024, at the age of 84. The funeral arrangements for the late Anderson Charles Bain, also known as Maskey and Brother B, of Fontenoy St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Marilyn Agnes Young of Duquesne, who resided at Nonpareil St. Mark, passed away on Monday, 3rd March 2024 in the USA, at the age of 77. The funeral arrangements for the late Marilyn Agnes Young of Duquesne, who resided at Nonpareil St. Mark, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Enid Butler, also known as Auntie Enid of St. Dominic Street, Grove, St. John, passed away on Tuesday, March 5th, 2024, at the age of 99. The funeral arrangements for the late Enid Butler, also known as Auntie Enid of St. Dominic Street, Grove, St. John, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. In loving memory of Henry Neffet Toussaint, who passed away on March 13th, 2023. In loving memory of Teresa Patsy Toussaint, who passed away on March 19th, 2023. Left to cherish their memories are their children Neil Horsford in the USA, Chris and Frank, Nikita in the United Kingdom, Nordica, Nikeshi, and Nikhil Toussaint. Grandchildren Tyrrell, Kimmy, Sai Toussaint, Nakia and Carlson Moses, and Jusam in the UK. You left us beautiful memories. Your love is still our guide. Although we cannot see you, you are always by our side. You are loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. Funeral arrangements were entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
I just want to express my sympathy with all those of you who have lost your loved ones. We know it is not an easy piece to lose somebody that you love dearly. But death is not the end, because the Bible tells us that there is life after death. My mind goes back to a man in the Bible named David, a man who at least he had a son by Uriah's wife, and the child got sick and died. In fact, the Bible says in verse 18 of 1 Samuel chapter 12, and it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died. The child died. But that was not the end. David began a series of mourning, laid on the ground, upon the earth, and he called on God to save his son, so that he can have sweet fellowship. He wanted to have time with his son. He wanted to have his son grow up to be the person that he wanted him to be. He probably wanted to play the first cricket match, or he probably wanted to go kick the first football in the field. Or he wanted probably him to climb the first tree. But yet for all, the Bible says your child died. David in himself satisfied that the sovereign God who gives and takes is able to do great things. Then David arose, the Bible says, from the earth and washed and anointed himself and changed his apparel and came into the house of the Lord to worship. David had the hope that he would see his beloved son again. And so, ladies and gentlemen out there that are in the mourning period, pick yourself up and recognize that if your loved one died in Christ, you are going to see them again. And the right thing to do is to come to that saving knowledge, recognizing who God is, and God is going to bring you through. And so I thank you, and I trust as we pray for you, you would cheer yourself and recognize that the sovereign God takes control of everything. God bless you.